2024, the 31st Annual Enterprise Awards, and I couldn't be more excited. Let's find Steph.
Oh,
there you are. So good to see you.
Good to see you. Good to be here again, right? And in this amazing venue.
So incredible. The history that exists here, 150 plus years.
Right. And the workmanship and the craftsmanship and the innovation that went into this building is just amazing.
Speaks to the innovation that we're going to honor tonight.
Absolutely.
Before we do so, though, we have something very important to do.
Here we go. Hi, Di. Merrill Hodge here. Your friends and family reached out to me, and let's just see, I hear about you in Philly. Fierce, loyal Steeler fan in Philly. Well, your family and friends and colleagues and yours truly here wish you a wonderful retirement. Now hang on, because there are a few more folks that you're going to hear from.
Diane's always been a top professional and a committed person to Philadelphia and Philadelphia business scene. It's truly been a pleasure, so I wish you nothing but the best.
Her performances at the Enterprise Award events were just legendary. Without you doing what you've been doing, there's no way we could have had the successes that we've had. Thank you, Diane.
Hi, Diane. Maybe we will see you at the Pittsburgh Vintage Grand Prix this year. Take care. Best of luck. Talk to you soon.
Congratulations, Diane, on your retirement. Throughout your career, you've made incredible contributions to PACT and the Philadelphia community. I can't wait to see how you apply your incredible talents and passions going forward.
I love you, Di. Hope you enjoy this next big chapter in your life.
May your wine glass always be full of health, happiness, love, and to new adventures. We love you, Diane. Cheers.
You deserve all the best in them, Dad. Here is to enjoying the fruits of your labor and all those years of hard work and having a wonderful and relaxing retirement. Congratulations. I love you.
I just want to say thanks for everything along the way and love you, and can't wait to share the next chapter with you.
I think of her love for me and everything she's done for me and everything she's sacrificed for me. And one day, I genuinely hope my kids have that same feeling towards me. I love you, Mom.
Can you say I love you, Grandma? I love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Diane Strunk! Diane Strunk! Please stand up and honor Di. Come on, Di. Come on. Come on, everybody. Come on down, Di.
In case it was not obvious, we just surprised Di. All right, Di.
Oh, Dean, I can't believe it. I should have known better.
Come on, come on stage.
So Di's whole family flew in to surprise her for this moment. 34 years deserves this. Diane has been synonymous with this community since 1991. Di has been synonymous with these awards that have been going on for over 30 years, but her impact has been far beyond the Enterprise Awards. And I have a little something to present to Di, which is a proclamation from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. So whereas the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania is always proud to acknowledge those individuals who, through professional excellence, bring credit, great credit to themselves in this Commonwealth, and whereas Diane Strunk is being honored upon her retirement from PACT after a career spanning nearly 34 years, whereas a founding member of the Eastern Technology Council in 1991, Ms. Strunk was instrumental in establishing the organization as a resource for starting and building high-growth technology companies. She launched the Enterprise Awards as a means of celebrating this region's accomplishments and successes, a tradition that continues today. In 2010, she joined the staff of PACT as vice president and has helped this region continue to grow, achieving a top five status in the nation for venture deals, throughout her career demonstrating remarkable knowledge, ability, integrity, and carrying out her many responsibilities. And now, therefore, the House of Representatives of the Commonwealth of PA congratulates Di on her well-deserved retirement and heartily recognizes her record of service. Her service. Diane is synonymous with these awards, and we also have tonight, presented by her sister, a lifetime achievement techie. Would you like to say any words?
I don't think I can. Oh. I really have no words. It's been a true honor and a privilege working for you and with you all these years, and I'm just so grateful for this recognition and for you all being here. And I'm not good on stage, you know, and speaking in a microphone, so I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you very much.
Diane Strunk, ladies and gentlemen. It is fair to say that no single individual in those 34 years has had the kind of impact that Di has had on this community. We miss her greatly. She's already left us. And you saw just some of the people that she's going to spend and already is spending more time with. But it's amazing to celebrate her. And thank you. This next segment's going to be a little harder. We lost somebody 3 weeks ago. If she was here, her smile would light up this room. Shermaina was a trusted partner to this community, to all of us. She loved these awards. Even before she worked for PAC, she used to volunteer every year. She wouldn't miss it. The community that she officially joined just a couple years ago was already embedded in her. We miss her incredibly. And we're grateful for all she has done and will continue to do in her spirit. Tonight, we honor her by dedicating these awards to Shermaina Rountree. Celebrate not just achievements, but also the spirit of community and innovation that propels us forward. At PACT, we are connectors and builders. We forge connections among founders, investors, and advisors, nurturing talent through programs like our Next Gen Leadership Program, fostering accessibility to capital, and promoting regional deal flow. One way of this is through pitching opportunities like those at our recent Forum Technology Conference, which focused on practical implementations of AI, and the Mid-Atlantic Capital Conference.
Now, this past year, according to the Philadelphia Venture Report, our report with PitchBook, our region ranked in the top 5 nationwide in venture deals, with nearly 100 enterprise tech deals closed. This is a testament to our resilience and determination.
Indeed. PACT's programs, ranging from tech, healthcare, and life sciences events to our investor series, aim to build connections and drive progress collaboratively. Many of the company names you see tonight, including PACT sponsors and board members, to our award judges and finalists, contribute to our community's economic and skill development with thought leadership and commitment to their mission. One such program is our upcoming Top Pitch event on June 4th, featuring presentations from founders and are supported by sponsors and partners like Ben Franklin Technology Partners of Southeastern PA, Comcast, NBC Universal Lyft Labs, Morgan Lewis, and Thai Philadelphia.
Indeed, and we're thrilled to announce that our program Apprenti PHL will begin offering a paid 15-week training plus a 1-year apprenticeship in software development. Hosted by PACT member companies, these apprenticeships will provide employers with top-tier underrepresented talent trained by PACT and our partners. We invite you to stay connected and join us at future events. And for more information, you can visit www.philadelphiapact.com/tech-events. Together, let's continue driving Philadelphia's bright and innovative future.
That's good stuff, isn't it, Steph?
Absolutely.
Speaking of looking forward and moving forward, tonight's program once again features a glimpse inside each of our finalists. Then, we're back live to present each category and finalists and announce the winners. And we'll hear from each winner live with their acceptance speech.
Ooh.
But don't worry, we're keeping things short and sweet.
We do love short and sweet, don't we? That's great, Dean. And then backstage, I'll be doing interviews with the winners, so be sure to visit PACT's YouTube channel to see tonight's entire program and festivities.
What do you think, Steph? Time to get started?
I think so. Let's do it.
These three companies have each made an incredible impact on the region's life sciences industry in a relatively short period of time and show great promise for growth in the years to come. Let's take a look at the nominees for life sciences and healthcare startup. Code Biotherapeutics.
At Code Bio, we're developing precision genetic medicines that address the unmet need of gene therapies today. We do this using our proprietary 3DNA platform. In this laboratory, we are developing the fully synthetic 3DNA platform that we will use to deliver genetic medicines to patients. Here, we're developing our DNA nanoparticle that consists of our payload, our 3DNA, and our targeting agent, which eventually, when pulled together, will be delivered to patients. Here we have final qualification of the DNA nanoparticle before it is used as a therapeutic. The idea is that we only have to dose you once, but if we have to, we can redose, which means that we can guarantee clinical efficacy for patients.
E-Cure.
At E-Cure, we are a gene editing company with a focus on loss of function disorders where a person's genes are not functioning properly, and the objective is to provide replacement genes in order to restore function for the person. There's different approaches that you can take for different diseases to get a good outcome for the patient. The diseases we're going after are a specific type, what we would call loss of function, where the patient's gene does not function. That loss of function causes devastating downstream effects for that patient, and they're all varied by what disease it is. But for example, in the ornithine transcarbamylase deficiency, that's a urea cycle disorder. That means that the patient has no ability to process ammonia because the gene is meant to process and help to excrete ammonia. When you don't do that, the ammonia goes to the patient's brain and causes many problems, up to and including death. So by placing the new gene in and having that corrected, we believe we can eliminate that whole downstream effect.
Trial B has a global platform to help connect patients and their families into clinical trials. We do this in three ways.
One of the ways is we have global reach around 48 countries in which we have a very sophisticated way of doing digital marketing.
Secondly, we have a technology platform called Honey. Honey is the workflow that all the patients go through to be screened and eligible for a trial so they can enroll, and then eventually be brought to the research site that's conducting the clinical research.
And the third part is our omnichannel network. This is a network of partners globally that meet patients where they are in their healthcare journey, whether that's through a disease community, an advocacy group, a digital application. Virtually any platform that has a voice for patients is an opportunity for TrialBee to reach out.
When you put these three things together, you can help enroll trials sooner by working with TrialBee.
The companies in our next category showcase the very best our innovation ecosystem has to offer and show incredible potential for future impact and success. Let's take a look at the nominees for Technology Startup of the Year. Carenostics.
At Carenostics, we find people with undiagnosed and undertreated chronic diseases earlier. We partner with health systems to help identify these populations earlier and give that information to their physicians to intervene.
Our proprietary AI takes all the EHR data within a health system, labs, diagnosis, clinical notes, and other information, analyzes it using our proprietary platform. The critical problem throughout my career in the use of healthcare AI is not the AI, but the clinical adoption. And that's where, in Carenostics, we make sure we go through to the last mile, where we use AI not just to identify the patients, but to help the physician treat the patients and get them on the optimal therapy and help them practice at the top of their license.
And this problem is very important to us personally. My grandfather passed away from kidney disease, but didn't know he had chronic kidney disease until his kidneys had already failed. Had he known 10, 15 years earlier, he could have been put on preventative treatment and might still be alive today. That's the problem we're tackling at Carenostics, to stop that story from repeating itself.
Mural Health Technologies.
Mural Health eliminates barriers that make it difficult for people to participate in clinical trials around the world. Emma Eichermann, our product manager, we'll show you a few ways that we do that.
So our app is available for clinical trial participants to use either on desktop or via the mobile phone. As you can see, they are able to claim money through the app, or they can also look at treatment information, add it to their calendar for reminders on their next appointment. If they had $25 ready to be transferred, they could go ahead and do that here. As you can see, I have Venmo as my selected payment option, but I could always change that. We have multiple options here through Mural Link. If I wanted to go ahead and transfer that, I could. We then asked participants to give us feedback on how their visit was. As you can see, how was your experience during treatment one, I'll give it a 9. We'll go ahead and submit that feedback. We also have the ability to have participants book an Uber through our app so they can go ahead and do this. So once a participant has submitted their reimbursements and claimed their money, they are all caught up, and that is Mural Link.
Red Vector.
At Red Vector, our mission is to help organizations worldwide increase the trust of their workforce to reduce workforce risk. We do this through a software platform we provide called Fulcrum. It utilizes advanced artificial intelligence and machine learning to help organizations measure behavioral indicators of risk so that they can mitigate issues before they become problems. Let me have Ali Luba, our Vice President of Product Management, tell you how Fulcrum operates.
Thank you, Steve. The Fulcrum platform is used by insider risk analysts within the organization, and they start their daily analysis on this dashboard. And the dashboard here presents to them based on disparate data that's been ingested from the corporation and from outside data sources, analyzes that data, and provides those analysts a set of leads or high-risk individuals for them to start their triage process. And here you see the list of those top 25 individuals, at which point then the analyst can drill down to the details behind any one of those individuals. And finally, the analysts use the case management features of the application to document their results and take responsive actions as needed.
And this is why our mission at Red Vector is so timely and important. These risks are increasing. almost daily. And they're not just cybersecurity risks. They're physical security, workplace security, espionage, sabotage, workplace violence, and the list continues on.
The Enterprise Awards could not be possible without the support of our title sponsor, Fairmount Partners. PACT is truly grateful for Fairmount's continued support as it represents the spirit of partnerships and community. It is with great pleasure I introduce Fairmount Partners, Alan Bourne.
Since our founding more than 20 years ago, we at Fairmount Partners have been proud to be part of the remarkable growth of the Philadelphia region, including co-founding PACT, helping to drive Ben Franklin Technology Partners, and working with many of you in the venture, private equity, and entrepreneurial community. And this year, we are honored to join PACT in recognizing the region's best and brightest for the 19th consecutive year as title sponsor of the Enterprise Awards. We join you in celebrating our joint achievements and the unique spirit of this region. We congratulate the finalists and winners, and we look forward to helping drive Philadelphia's future together.
As we at Fairmount Partners reflect on our journey and the vibrant city we proudly call home, it's clear that our success is deeply intertwined with the spirit and resilience of Philadelphia itself. Just as the city continues to thrive and evolve, so too do we adapt and grow. Philadelphia is a top five city for venture capital, biotech, and the sciences. We're retaining record numbers of graduates from the area's more than 100 colleges and universities, and we're one of the top cities in the world for sports, food, and the arts. In the 21 years since our founding, we have seen two market bubbles, three recessions, and a pandemic. Through it all, we are proud to have been a steady hand for our clients, completing more than 290 transactions across 24 countries, totaling over $17 billion in transaction value spanning the technology, healthcare, consulting and technology services, and industrial and consumer industries. When we consider the drivers of our longevity and success, many of our core strengths mirror those of Philadelphia region and are reflected in the success we've had with our clients, including tenacity, dedication, partnership, creativity, expertise. We at Fairmount Partners are optimistic about the future, and as we look forward, we remain committed to serving our clients and colleagues in this region with unwavering dedication and integrity as we navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. We believe that, together, our best days are ahead of us.
Our three finalists for Life Sciences and Healthcare Investment Deal exhibit a full breadth of the life sciences and healthcare community in our region. These companies have forged a uniquely successful growth pattern with their recent investment deals. Our finalists for Life Sciences and Healthcare Investment Deal are Harmony Biosciences.
Harmony Biosciences is a profitable, rapidly growing pharmaceutical company, and we're focused on developing and commercializing innovative products for patients living with rare neurological diseases who have unmet medical needs. One of our exciting opportunities last year in 2023 was the acquisition of Zynerba Pharmaceuticals, which brought in two late-stage development programs in the orphan rare neuropsychiatry space.
We acquired the entire company as part of a tender offer, which included the two assets that Jeff just described in Fragile X syndrome and 22q deletion syndrome, and also the employees at Zynerba who'd been shepherding those programs for many, many years. So they became part of the Harmony Biosciences team going forward, and we're very happy to have them.
The importance of that with regards to the acquisition of Zynerba Pharmaceuticals and bringing in ZYN002, it was a excellent strategic fit, you know, for Harmony with regards to our area of expertise in orphan rare diseases and in the neurology space, and this as an adjacency. You know, in addition, it brought in late stage development programs to sort of advance our pipeline and with excellent, you know, deal terms with regards to the company profile.
Mineralis.
Yeah, Mineralis was formed in late 2020 through a licensing agreement with Mitsubishi Tanabe. And we did a Series A and a Series B financing to really underwrite the development of this compound. We knew going into a chronic condition like hypertension that we would need capital. We would need high quality investors to support that and enable our IPO. And that's what we were able to do. We basically, on the heels of the Series B, had a syndicate of investors that we knew were committed to the story, committed to addressing the unmet need in hypertension specifically. And that was part of our plan to markets, you know, allowing to move into being a public company, getting access to the capital that would allow us to, you know, drive forward with our development program with lorundrostat. And that's what we've been fortunate to do, thanks to our investors, thanks to the story that we have, and thanks to the unmet need in the space.
SK Pharmteco.
The Center for Breakthrough Medicines was launched in 2019 as the Center of Excellence for Cell and Gene Therapy Manufacturing based here in King of Prussia. We're proud to announce that last year we were acquired by SK Pharmteco via a significant investment to take majority of our firm. We're now part of a global organization, including sites in Korea, France, Ireland, and throughout the United States. With that footprint, we plan to be the number one CDMO in outsourced manufacturing.
This category showcases the remarkable transactions that keep our region alive. Mergers, acquisitions, and influx of capital for growth, all demonstrating the full breadth of moving forward for continued success.
There's been no shortage of successful investment deals in the region over the past year, especially in the technology sector.
But which deal has been selected by our judges as Technology Investment Deal of the Year? Let's meet the finalists.
Click.
This deal that we're just finishing out the first year on was the acquisition of a company called Talent. So Click, with our heritage in analytics, knew that we saw a trend towards AI and the use of artificial intelligence and needing more kind of data from a variety of sources as well as confidence in that data. And we acquired a company called Talent. This effectively brought our company from one main product area of analytics to adding in a data foundation. And this merger took us to a total value or AR, annualized reoccurring revenue of $1.3 billion.
Tendo.
When Dan and I created Tendo back in 2020, we were really focused on creating this trusted connection between patients, clinicians, caregivers, and now navigators, employers, and employees. And we do this by providing software that leverages AI, advanced analytics, and machine learning to create clinical, operational, and quality insights that are actionable. So creating appointments from that or creating surveys from that, leading to these actions that can make a difference in somebody's business. And then even things like purchasing care in our healthcare marketplace over time.
And with the addition of MD Save through this acquisition, we significantly leap forward the consumer experience where patients can not only seek, schedule, and engage in care, they have the opportunity to transact in healthcare in a transparent and affordable way. MD Save adds the most comprehensive healthcare network with proprietary and patented healthcare bundles so patients can easily consume healthcare. These three things combined, Tendo's application platform and workflow solutions, our advanced analytics and AI technology, and now the marketplace capabilities for individual patients and employer-sponsored healthcare plans, allows us to create the most consumer-grade and engaging experience in healthcare today.
Transcend.
Transcend is a generative design software as a service company. So what does that actually mean? It means we have a software platform where if somebody's designing any kind of critical infrastructure, a water treatment plant, an electrical substation, a road, an apartment building, they can log in on the internet enter some data in just 5 or 10 minutes, hit a button, and it'll automatically generate a preliminary design for that particular kind of infrastructure, which today is something that is done manually and takes hundreds or thousands of hours to do. So we are a venture-backed startup. We spun out from a previous engineering company that I ran before, which was focused on the water industry about 4 years ago. We raised a seed financing round when we spun out and did a Series A about a year and a half later. And last year we did a $20 million Series B financing round. The round included some of our existing investors, which are venture capital funds that are focused on climate technology and sustainability, as well as Autodesk, which is the largest design software company in the world. It also included a number of electric utilities that are working on making our grid green and promoting more renewable energy.
PACT's judging partner, KPMG, oversees a judging process that is at once thoughtful and rigorous, a true deep dive selection process that has a myriad of factors and considerations. Here, joining us once again, is KPMG's Andy Cherry.
For over 30 years, excitement and anticipation abound as the judging process gets underway for PACT's Enterprise Awards. This time-honored tradition is at the forefront of taking a close look at the many success stories that define the resilient, visionary, and ever-enduring spirit of the PACT community. KPMG is honored once again to serve as judging partner for the Enterprise Awards. This is a celebration of the Greater Philadelphia region's most prestigious business honors for technology and life sciences companies, their leaders, and entrepreneurs. Our panel of judges are industry leaders, each dedicated to the judging process, and each lending their expertise and knowledge across industry sectors that define our region's economic strength. Many of the companies and individuals selected as a finalist can attribute their mercurial rise as eager participants in Mentor Connect program. The Mentor Connect journey, from inception through discovery and constant adaptability, all the way to measured success, are the stories that continue to inspire and motivate all of us. As we at KPMG, along with our esteemed panel of judges, embark on the 2024 Enterprise Awards judging process, know that we carry the rich history entrusted in us with the same excitement and enthusiasm as the past 30 years.
The Life Sciences and Healthcare Emerging Award honors the accomplishments of companies that have passed the startup stage with a record of success that indicates strong potential for growth. Let's take a look at this year's nominees. Adaptimmune.
So here's the problem with cancer. Your immune system can't see it. So what we do at Adaptimmune is we engineer a patient's own T cells, part of their immune system, to be able to recognize their cancer. To do this, we use a proprietary technology that was spun out from the University of Oxford over 20 years ago. And behind me, our engineers are inserting genes into patients' own cells. These genes enable those cells to be able to recognize their cancer and to kill it. We have a pipeline of programs, the most advanced of which is with the FDA now and will be our first product this year. But they target a wide range of what are called solid tumors. These are cancers like ovarian cancer, sarcomas, head and neck cancer, and bladder cancer. And our intent with these engineered T cells is to revolutionize how cancer is treated and have a major impact on patients around the world with a wide variety of cancers.
Bioanalysis.
Bioanalysis is a collaborative research organization specializing in analytical testing for cell and gene therapy. We provide analytical testing for all cell and gene therapy companies specializing in biophysics, mass spectrometry, and we go from discovery all the way to manufacturing.
Bioanalysis has 7 AUCs under GMP. We also have proprietary software that's 21 CFR Part 11 compliant. We leverage our experience with our software to analyze the most complex and interesting samples in the industry.
Cell and gene therapy are curative medicines. And by us providing these expertise and analytical testing, we are playing a vital role in the patient population, ensuring the safety of the cell and gene therapy products.
MVACs.
Invax is a clinical stage biotech company based here in Philadelphia with 50 employees. We utilize a unique technological approach based on our Goldspire platform. We treat solid tumors, which have proven very difficult to treat in the past, and our principal focus is on glioblastoma. And we are in a pivotal phase 2b study, which we expect to read out results in 2025.
Patient tissue arrives to us here at the Curtis Center in Philadelphia. We take that tissue, incubate it with an antisense oligonucleotide, fill it into patented biodiffusion chambers. We do all the quality testing and release here at the Curtis Center, and then that therapy is couriered direct back to the clinical site for implantation into the patient. The patient will be implanted, and 48 hours later, the chambers will be explanted. In that time frame, the body's immune system will take over, and then the therapy runs its course. People often ask, why do you do what you do? Your manufacturing hope is what drives us here every day.
This next category highlights emerging companies that have demonstrated innovation and competitive advantage while achieving major milestones for growth.
And also showcasing the strength, grit, and agility of their management teams.
The nominees for Technology Emerging Company of the Year are
Burrow.
Burrow is an autonomous mobility company headquartered here in Philadelphia with an office in Visalia, California. Our mission as a company is to rid the world of tedious work outdoors through the use of collaborative robots. What makes our robot special is that it uses computer vision and AI for its navigation so that it can move around the world. We use our patented pop-up autonomy so that the robot can follow a person or learn a planned path and repeat it throughout the day. We started working in agriculture, primarily in table grapes, citrus, and blueberries. Places where there's a lot of labor, where the robot can work collaboratively alongside people. This is our person follow function. You select it here on the screen, stand in front of the robot, and our Burrow uses computer vision in order to attach to someone and follow them. It's that easy. We have over 350 robots in paid commercial use throughout the world.
Cesium.
At Cesium, we provide a platform to enable software developers to build 3D experiences and simulations with geospatial data, creating digital twins of the real world. This could be showing a design model for a building in the context of the surrounding city, or it could be planning a mission to the moon. You can think of Cesium's technology similar to a video game engine, but instead of making virtual worlds that an artist created, a developer can use real-world data captured from satellites, drones, aircrafts, or even your cell phone to build a digital twin. We serve several communities: aerospace, defense, architecture, engineering, and construction. All of these benefit from 3D simulation to be more efficient, to be more safe, and to be more environmentally friendly.
DrayNow.
At DrayNow, we build technology for the intermodal logistics industry. Think about intermodal, nothing more than the ports and rails in the U.S., those containers need to get out to the final destination. We build technology that makes that final truck movement more efficient, more visible, and clearer for our customers. Focus on the core of the transaction, which is from the driver's seat. Build it really simple, make it user-friendly, and make sure it gives our customers what they want. They want transparency, visibility, document transfer, and they also want to do it in the most efficient manner that helps reduce carbon footprint in the transportation movement. We do it because it's a passion of mine. I've been around this industry about 32 years. The last 12 have been trying to solve this specific technology need in this industry. I really have a desire to make the exchange easier for the truck drivers and our customers by giving them visibility, the tools they need, listen to their needs, and build solutions that just make sense.
Each nominee in this next category has a clear vision for transforming healthcare, and through expertise and hard work,
has led their company towards making that vision a reality. Let's meet our nominees for the Life Sciences and Healthcare CEO Award.
Donna Drzinski, Just-in-Time GCP.
So the name Just-in-Time GCP is actually a little bit of a play on words. The majority of our clients call us Just-in-Time. So they don't hire us at the very beginning when they need to establish business process. It's more closer to when they're anticipating a potential inspection, or maybe they've had an inspection that hasn't gone well, or they're getting ready to maybe plan their phase three pivotal trial. However, just-in-time is a little bit of a play of words, and that when I started the business, my children were somewhat young, and my youngest son's name is actually Justin. So the idea was that putting just-in-time into the name of the company reminded me of the foundation of family and being a family-friendly organization.
Her genuine care for her team, for others. She invests time in understanding their needs, supporting their development, and truly investing in them.
Donna is open for allowing people growth and opportunities.
Practical example is that actually today, Donna is at a conference for only one reason, and that's that somebody that doesn't even report to her, this person reports to me. And it's her first time giving a presentation. And so Donna got on a plane and went to sit in the front row for this person in support to make them feel less anxious about it and all that. I mean, that's just really an astounding thing for me. For somebody as busy as Donna to be able to do that over multiple days, I just think that's like a really good practical example of her living what she talks about.
Hervé, Openo, Insight?
We are a company that is exploring new biologies, that is developing new product, creating new product, developing them, and hopefully when they are successful, changing the practice of medicine for physicians around the world.
So one of the things I think is pretty amazing, I've been with Insight for a long time, so 22 years, and Hervé joined about 10 years ago. And the thing that has been very consistent is the way we view the company. And we really look at it as, you know, patients are the most important thing to what our mission is and what we're doing. Employees are equally as important to us, and then the science. And so they're kind of these three things that most of our employees globally get behind. So when Hervé came 10 years ago, it was great to have someone that wanted to continue to be a partner and continue to emphasize how we build our company with our employees and how we treat them. And it's been an opportunity for both of us to continue to grow, and it's pulled through, again, across the globe, as well as at all different levels.
I think, you know, what's important to us is to as I said, is to explore. We are like exploring, you know, exploring places that have not been looked at before, and trying to get from that to what will be new medicine to help people around the world. So it's a big... it's a big goal, and it's very motivating.
James, love it. Myonex.
I think of James as like a real life CEO. So James cares about people. He cares about the business. He cares about processes. He's a caring leader. And I think that's really important for a business of our size, of somebody that can connect with the individuals in the company and also outside of the organization as well.
He's incredibly engaging with the employees, the customers, the supply partners, and that's a big part of why he's so successful.
Our long-term vision is to make clinical trials less costly and go faster. 80% of clinical trials run behind schedule, and the vast majority runs over budget. By providing more cost-efficient solutions, and especially by eliminating waste, we can help make that time and cost go better. And the result is drugs get developed faster, they get to market faster, which potentially saves lives. And ultimately, if we do that, our business will grow. That will help us hire more people and create career opportunity for our people, and we're contributing to society. So we are really excited about that.
The role of CEO encompasses a full breadth of the understanding of how to successfully guide a company with a clear vision while staying at the forefront of today's ever-evolving advances in technology.
And now, let's meet our nominees for Technology CEO of the Year, three dynamic leaders who have led their companies to achieve great success while earning the sincere respect of their teams and industry peers.
Suchit Bachali, Unilog.
So Unilog is a enterprise software technology platform. However, the true value is really in enabling and simplifying growth for our customers.
Proud to be here at Unilog, where we were named one of the great places, or certified as a great place to work in 2023. Super proud of it because I think it really came from the employees. Our employees were surveyed, and the vast majority of our employees voted us to be that great place to work. And I think that really does speak to the leadership that we get from our CEO, Suchit. Suchit really deeply believes in the individual and empowering the individual, both with our customers and our employees. He's really been able to foster an environment where people feel empowered and accountable to their work product, and I think that really shows in the products and services we deliver to our customers.
He really cares about people and the outcomes of this business. His vision for the Unilog brand and the company going forward is such that it excites me.
I see a very bright future for Unilog because we are passionate about the markets that we serve, and we really want to help them create the best digital versions of their businesses online.
Brian Danis, CuraTech.
Brian's the first one to, you know, encourage us to think outside the box. And, you know, my own personality anyway was, you know, I always want to help people. So I was always inclined not to say no. But after working with Brian for a bit, my thinking really shifted. And I think the people that are attracted to working here and staying here are the ones who enjoy that push.
I would say that's probably his strongest suit, is just his adaptability to working through a particular problem in a very structured way. And all the while he's working on it in a very creative manner.
One area that has really given us a major advantage is that we've gotten really specific in the types of technologies that we work with. So one of our core technology platforms is a framework called Laravel. So just the way that we've positioned the company inside of the Laravel ecosystem has been a major lever for our growth over the years.
Carla Trotman, Electrosoft.
What excites me about today is that we are a Gen 1 company in Gen 2 phase. It's hard to take a company that was a startup, in essence, for over 30 years to a growing business. Electrosoft was a lifestyle company, but now we see the need for stateside manufacturing, and we've taken that information and we're going to the next level.
Carla found out that I couldn't go to school. She gave me different connections where I can connect with different people to help me to get into school, because I was very scared at one point. But she told me it would be fine. You're gonna get somewhere. You're gonna get in school, and you're gonna get a degree and everything, because you need one.
I think sky's the limit in the next 20 years. I think Carla's management skills and her leadership quality is gonna help the company grow two or three times in the next 4 or 5 years.
My hope is that my children will want to be a part of this business. But I've learned that with family business and legacy, there's still a way to pass it along without working in the company. So I'm teaching my children the ability of learning how to run a company and own a company without working in a company.
This category celebrates companies and solutions poised to significantly impact cost, quality, and access in healthcare and life sciences, and to improve the lives of people across our region and around the world. The nominees for this year's Healthcare Innovator Award are Acela Health.
Acela Health is a provider of specialty pharmaceuticals to patients who have complex, rare, and chronic conditions on behalf of pharmaceutical and biotech companies, payers, and providers. It's more than just sending medications to their homes or to their doctor's offices where they might get those medications. It's always also around how, if there's financial assistance, if they need any kind of service around getting to the doctor's office, any other support, education, information on the medications or their disease, we're there to help them. In addition to that, we try to do that in a very technological approach. We try to use patient engagement tools. We try to help them and contact them and communicate with them through their mobile phones, if that's what they want us to do. Even email, traditional phone calls, whatever the patient really needs, we're going to try to support them in any type of communication modality that they see fit. And then the other part that we really try to do is come up with innovative ways to help payers and pharmaceutical companies, one, get their medications paid for, but also, is there a better way to deliver these medications more efficiently and even more cost-effective to the whole healthcare system?
Cabaletta Bio.
Cabaletta Bio, we're developing engineered T-cell therapies for patients with autoimmune disease to develop potential cures for those autoimmune diseases. We're taking patient cells, engineering them outside the body, and reinfusing them in order to deliver those potential cures. Our lead product candidate is a product by the name of CABA-201, which is a CD19 CAR T product candidate and is currently being developed in 4 phase 1-2 clinical trials for different autoimmune diseases, which are lupus, myositis, systemic sclerosis, and myasthenia gravis. And we're really excited about that moving forward this year.
Charisma Therapeutics.
Charisma Therapeutics is the leader in engineered macrophages. We take a fundamental understanding of macrophage biology and combine it with cell engineering tools to create therapeutics that address indications with unmet medical need. Things like solid tumors, things like liver fibrosis. We've been able to take our platform and create 4 different shots on goal that include a HER2 CAR-M program for oncology. We have a second ex vivo program targeting mesothelin. We have a third program that takes the same ideas and uses an in vivo approach or an off-the-shelf approach to address cancer as well. Lastly, we have a liver fibrosis program, which is an opportunity for us to take the deep understanding and apply it to non-oncology applications. All of these programs are moving forward rapidly, and if all goes well, we hope to have 4 clinical stage assets by the end of 2025.
Are you ready? Are you ready? All right, it is time for the 2024 Enterprise Awards. Wow, some amazing, amazing videos of these companies. If you haven't been on the awards before, this is the fast-paced segment of the program, and then we're going to get you out after we recognize the winners. First, a round of applause for all of our finalists. All right, here we go. Life Sciences and Healthcare. Presenting the award for the Life Sciences and Healthcare Startup, please welcome Josh Strober, partner in the Corporate and M&A and Securities Group at Blank Rome.
Thank you, Dean. Our finalists for the Life Sciences and Healthcare Startup Award are Code Biotherapeutics, EACure, and TrialB. And the winner is EACure.
Accepting the award is CEO Joseph Truitt.
Well, thank you very much. This is quite an honor. I know I have to be quick, so I really want to thank the gene therapy program at Penn, who we are basically just taking their science forward. They've been working on this program for a decade. I also want to thank our investors. We have a tremendous group of investors who've put $130 million behind this management team. We have a tremendous management team. 3 of them are here with me this evening, and I want to thank them. Starting a company is not just about doing the operations, but everything that goes with it. We have an incredible group of people that work with us in Bluebell, Pennsylvania, just an awesome group. And I also want to thank all the people that support EACure, in particular Ernst & Young, Goodwin, all the Fortrea, all the different vendors that support us, because we're just a small group supported by quite a large infrastructure of just amazing talent and terrific people. So the last thing is to the patients. The cavalry's coming because this disease is devastating, and if it works, we will cure this disease, and that's an amazing evolution of innovation and that'll really change the world for those folks. So thank you very much.
Congratulations. You're going to go off that one. All right, here to present the award for the technology startup is Tom Dwyer, partner at Troutman Pepper.
The finalists for the Technology Startup Award are CareNostics, Mural Health, and Red Vector. And the winner is... That was great. Great company, great entrepreneur, Mural Health.
Accepting the award is co-founder and CEO, Sam Whitaker.
Thanks to everyone for the recognition. We appreciate it. We have a long way to go. Thanks to all of the people that work with me. I appreciate it.
Presenting the award for the Life Sciences and Healthcare Investment Deal is Betsy Rath, Managing Director at Bank of America.
Okay, thank you, Dean. Our finalists for the Life Sciences and Healthcare Investment Deal Award are Harmony Biosciences, Mineralis, and SK Pharmteco. And the winner is, this is heavy, Mineralis.
Accepting the award is Senior Vice President of Quality Assurance, Danny Bradbury.
Hi, I'd like to thank everybody for putting the stairs back on the stage because I was worried about falling. But now this is really exciting for us at Mineralis. As starting out as a small company in the pandemic and going virtual, we're still virtual, so we're able to get talented people from around the world to work for us. And bringing a drug like lorundrostat to the market for patients with uncontrolled hypertension is really exciting for us. So we thank our investors, our dedicated team as well, and all of you for this. Thank you.
Presenting the award for the technology investment deal is Senior Director of Enterprise Sales at Comcast Business, Joe Moore, and JP Morgan's Justin O'Malley and Joe Bianconello.
Our finalists for technology investment deal of the year are
Click, Tendo, Transcend.
I don't know where my envelope went, but the winner is Click.
Accepting the award is Click's Chief Financial Officer, Dennis Johnson.
Congratulations.
Thank you, everybody. Accepting this award is really a testament to our employees, other hard work on the integration to ensure that it was successful. And a big thank you to our investors at Thoma Bravo, and thank you to PACT for all they do for the technology community here in Philadelphia. Thanks again.
Thanks, guys.
Here to present the award for Life Sciences and Healthcare Emerging is Mike Romano, RSM Financial Consulting Partner and National Biopharma Industry Co-Leader.
Our finalists for the Life Sciences and Healthcare Emerging Award are Adaptimmune, Bioanalysis, and Imvax. And the winner is Imvax.
Accepting the award is Chief Executive Officer John Fury.
Uh,
Thank you very much to all of the sponsors, to the judges. This is a wonderful recognition of the IMVAX team, but more importantly, a wonderful recognition of the patients we serve. Today's an exciting day for IMVAX. We just enrolled our last patient in a very important phase 2B trial for patients with glioblastoma. And for those that you know about glioblastoma, it is a dreadful disease with a very poor prognosis. So hopefully, this is the first of many recognitions on our journey to helping glioblastoma patients. Thank you very much.
Presenting the Technology Emerging Award is Gretchen Rohde, President and CEO of Broadpath Communications, and Liz Sigety, partner at Fox Rothschild.
The finalists for Technology Emerging Award are Burrow, Cesium, and DrainOw. And the winner of the Technology Emerging Award is DrainOw.
Accepting the award is DrainOw's CEO and co-founder, Mike Albert.
Wow, didn't expect that. This is truth. Truth, there's other things in this city other than healthcare. Not take anything away from anybody. Listen, I have 24 dedicated employees that four of them are here with me, Courtney, Megan, Michael, and Chris, who are amazing, talented folks. I learned as a CEO, set strategy and stay away. Let your folks with the passion really help guide the vision. And I thank you four that are here, the other 19 associates who are also with us. The other thing I wanted to say is, thank you to all my investors. Some are here today, specifically Osage. Comcast was an early investor with us, and also a newer investor, Ben Franklin. Thank you very much if you're in the room. And lastly, this is our second award we actually won. We won an award several years back. And one thing I forgot to mention then was, for all of us, this is incredible, but most importantly, the foundation of who we are is our families. For what we do here, and for all my employees, our culture at our company is family first, and any of my associates would also say that. I want to thank my family, I want to thank your families, and I'm sure for every CEO I speak for that. Our families are what guides us. This is all just icing on the cake. Thank you very much.
Presenting the award for Life Sciences and Healthcare CEO, please welcome EY partner Ryan Murray and Morgan Lewis partner Doug Kingston.
The finalists for the Life Sciences and Healthcare CEO Award are Donna Dorzinski, Hervé Opino, and James Lovett.
And the winner is Hervé Opino.
Unfortunately, Hervé is out of the country. Insight Executive Director Catalina Lovman will accept the award on his behalf.
On behalf of Hervé, I'd like to extend his gratitude. He is a very, very proud leader of our company. We have more than 2,500 people around the world who are really doing everything they can to find solutions, and as he said, transformative medicines for patients around the world. He's sorry he can't be here tonight, but is very thankful, and on his behalf, I extend that gratitude to you. Thank you.
Here to present the award for Technology CEO is Cozen O'Connor's co-chair of the Emerging Business and Venture Capital Practice, Chris McDemus.
Good
All right. The finalists for the Technology CEO Award are Suchit Bachali, Brian Danis, and Carla Trotman. And the winner is Suchit Bachali, Unilog.
Please join me in congratulating Suchit Bachali.
There's a good saying, be direct, be brief, and be gone. I'm going to directly speak to the entrepreneurs in the room. They say entrepreneurship and being a CEO is a lonely job. I have never felt that way. Every time I looked around me, I found a helping hand. I found a listening ear, a shoulder to lean on, and some of the brightest and sharpest minds that I get to wake up and go to work with. So thank you for all of that, and to all the entrepreneurs in the room, look around you. This is your support group. Let's go. Thank you.
All right, our final award of the evening. Presenting the award for Healthcare Innovator is Nate Gatch, Director of Innovation for Independence Blue Cross.
The finalists for the Healthcare Innovator Award are Acela Health, Cabaletta Bio, Charisma Therapeutics, and the winner is Cabaletta Bio.
Accepting the award is Cabaletta Bio's Chief Business Officer, Arun Das.
Well, it's never great to be the last person who's standing between the award ceremony and what I think is drinks and a celebration, but I really want to thank the PACT organization. At Cabaletta, we've got about 130 employees with a single North Star. It's to deliver curative medicines for patients with autoimmune disease, broadening the reach of CAR T therapies into autoimmunity is why we were founded in 2018. It's why the 130 people at our company do what we do. Just incredibly grateful to be one member of that 130 person group and excited for the progress that we have in front of us. Thank you all.
All right, he's not the last person, it's me, but it's gonna be brief. All right, another round of applause for all of our finalists and winners. It is time to celebrate. And as we close out the ceremony portion of tonight's event, I want to emphasize that PACT continues to focus on two critical pillars for success, capital and talent. You know about the programs that we deploy. There are new ones coming along. These are foundations upon which we build our future. Driving innovation and growth in our industry is critical, critical for growth, and supporting that growth has been our sponsors. Please, a round of applause for all of our sponsors. And for PACT as a membership organization, our members are critical, and we thank you for that, as well as our partners. We want you to join us. Join us in shaping this vibrant, equitable community and an ecosystem that is growing. I want to reiterate our deep appreciation and support for all of our sponsors, and in particular, Fairmount Partners and KPMG, our title sponsor and our judging sponsor, who have been with us for so many years. We are grateful for your support, and we look forward to doing more things together. But again, all of our sponsors, we are so grateful for your support of this community, for the entrepreneurs. You heard some words about how hard it is, and we know how hard it is, and this group and this community is here to support you. So with that crucial support, our work is not done in supporting and growing. We know that together we can continue to build a dynamic future for the next group of entrepreneurs. And so with that, congratulations, and I will see you outside.